Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Ohayo gozaimasu. First and foremost, I wish to express my sincere appreciation and congratulations to the Japan Association of Travel Agents, JATA, for organizing the Global Tourism Forum in conjunction with the Tourism Expo Japan 2017. I would also like to thank JATA for inviting me to deliver a keynote address at this forum. Tourism is one of the key sectors in international trade and one of the main wealth creators for many developing countries, including Malaysia, especially in producing economic and employment benefits, as well as in the protection and promotion of our natural and cultural heritage in many related sectors, from construction to agriculture and telecommunications. Now, these dynamics have turned tourism into a key driver for socio-economic progress in nations worldwide, as we are moving to an economic growth scenario that is more inclusive and sustainable. Sustainable tourism development is no longer just a mere cliche, but has become a major contributor to a more environmentally sustainable economy. In the case of Malaysia, tourism has been identified as one of the 12 national key economic areas, the NKEAs, to propel the country's economic transformation. Now, in this regard, the Malaysia Tourism Information Plan, MTTP, was formulated and implemented in 2011 to help achieve the target of 36 million international tourist arrivals and generating USD 40.8 billion in tourism receipts by 2020. The MTTP is expected to transform the tourism landscape to be more vibrant and competitive, with tourist arrivals increasing by 1.5 times and tourist expenditures expanding by 3 times by 2020. Business opportunities in areas such as hotels, food and beverage outlets, transportation, as well as tour operators and travel agencies have been identified. These initiatives are projected to generate USD 16.3 billion in terms of GNI and create 500,000 additional job opportunities by 2020. In this context, 12 entry point projects, the EPPs we call it, have been developed to support the MTTP, and among them is establishing Malaysia as a global biodiversity hub, which aims to increase tourism revenue by establishing the country as one of the world's premium nature and ecotourism destination. Ladies and gentlemen, at this juncture, I would like to take this opportunity to share with you some of the ongoing initiatives on the development of sustainable tourism in Malaysia. We have formulated the National Ecotourism Plan 2016-2025 to maximize the potential of ecotourism and ensure sustainability. The plan also embodies the spirit of the theme, uplifting communities, opportunities, and economies. This theme focuses on the outputs, outcomes, and benefits of ecotourism, which is the left-hand side of the equation, but more importantly, the right-hand side variables involving the inputs of responsible tourism and sustainable development policy and practices are accorded due priority in the plan. Ecotourism, a sunrise industry, is increasing in popularity across the world. According to the NWTO, ecotourism, nature, heritage, culture, and adventure are expected to grow rapidly over the next 2 decades, and global spending will increase at a higher rate than the overall growth of tourism. Based on the estimates of the International Ecotourism Society, ecotourism is projected to grow by 25% of the global tourism market within 6 years, and generate USD 470 billion in tourist receipts. As for Malaysia, the data does not cater to a dedicated category of on ecotourism. The departing visitor survey, however, provides information on the major activities engaged by tourists visiting Malaysia. In this regard, the survey findings indicate that 30.4% of tourists are engaged in walking, hiking, and trekking related activities, which is related to ecotourism. This implies that ecotourism is relatively popular amongst tourists to Malaysia. Ecotourism is a term which basically means responsible tourism. It plays an important role in reducing the loss of biodiversity in the region and is able to provide an alternative source of income, becoming a positive economic incentive for communities that would otherwise utilize the forest in destructive ways, such as logging and agriculture. This is in line with the mantra of the Ministry of Tourism and Culture Malaysia that tourism protects, preserves, and conserves Mother Nature, culture, and heritage. In addition, the 11th Malaysia Plan 2016 to 2020, a five-year development plan, amongst others, is geared towards attracting high-yield tourists to further increase the industry's contribution to the economy. The strategies include upgrading and development of ecotourism infrastructure, enhancement of offerings, capacity building, and implementation of sustainable tourism development best practices, as well as marketing and promotion. To strengthen our position as one of the leading destinations for ecotourism in the region, measures have been undertaken to position Perhentian Island, one of the best-known islands in the world, in Terengganu, as a premier tourism eco and adventure destination. Through this latest initiative, we aim to emulate the success of Langkawi Island, which is renowned as an ecotourism geopark and island tourism destination in the world. In recognition of our ecotourism initiative, Malaysia was awarded the Best Eco Vacation at the 5th National Geographic Traveller Awards Top Travel Destination of 2015 by the National Geographic Traveller magazine. Now, ladies and gentlemen, a fundamental requirement of the tourism sector is that it should embrace the principles of sustainable tourism and focus on the achievement of sustainable development goals. Sustainable tourism should not be regarded as a separate component of tourism, as a set of niche products, but rather as a condition of the tourism sector as a whole, which should work to become more sustainable. The UNWTO has defined sustainable tourism as tourism that takes full account of its current and future economic, social, and environmental impacts, addressing the needs of visitors, the industry, the environment, and host communities. The UNWTO also acknowledged Malaysia's effort in promoting community-based tourism through the Malaysian Homestay Experience Programme, which won the Alessis Award for Innovation, Public Policy and Governance by UNWTO in 2012. Our Homestay Programme is a classic example of a rural ecotourism programme which empowers the communities to uplift their income and quality of life. This programme allows tourists to live with a local family, thus enabling them to experience their local lifestyle, culture, and tradition. In 2016, more than 410,522 tourists participated in the homestay program, generating USD 6.5 million to the rural economy. The homestay program also underlines the importance of conservation and environmental management. The tree planting program is a good example where visitors are given the opportunity to plant their own tree to mark their visit to a particular homestay dwelling. It also supports the idea of preserving the environment and further beautifying the landscape of the homestay. And to date, more than 16,733 trees have been planted by the homestay visitors. While we place emphasis on enhancing yield, we must be mindful not to overlook an important stakeholder of tourism, the people. Social inclusion is essential, and we need to strike a good balance between the maximization of economic returns and social returns. Thus, local involvement, enhancement of local capabilities, sense of belonging and ownership, economic empowerment and employment opportunities are essential ingredients for developing and managing ecotourism in a sustainable manner to cater to the socio-economic needs of local communities. It is also important to seek opportunities to create value innovation to enhance the ecotourism experience. For instance, initiatives to improve the training of local and special interests, traditional values, and ensure viable long-term economic operations, providing socio-economic benefits to all stakeholders that are fairly distributed, including stable employment and income earning opportunities and social services to host communities and contributing to poverty elevation. Now, sustainable tourism development entails the informed participation of all relevant stakeholders, as well as strong political leadership to ensure wider participation and consensus building. Attaining sustainable tourism is a continuous process and it requires constant monitoring of impacts, introducing the necessary preventive and corrective measures whenever necessary. Sustainable tourism should also maintain a high level of tourist satisfaction and ensure a meaningful experience to the tourists, raising their awareness about sustainability issues and promoting sustainable tourism practices amongst them. Finally, I would like to once again congratulate JATA for their remarkable effort and excellent arrangement in hosting this forum. I wish all of you fruitful deliberations and look forward to your ideas, suggestions and recommendations to uplift sustainable tourism to even greater heights. Thank you very much.